James chapter 5 that talks about that also. And so what we want to do is continually get in the minds of people the need of getting in the Bible, the need of being careful what we listen to. Because if we listen to these people, even as it states in 2 Timothy chapter 2, look in verse 17, the word will eat as doth a canker. So it will cause sickness. It will cause people to become gangrene. And what happens when something becomes gangrene? It's cut off. And this is what happens to people who don't abide in the word, do not stay in the doctrine of Jesus Christ. It states that according to St. John chapter 15, they're going to be cut off and they're going to be cast into the fire. What is that fire? That's hell. That's the lake of fire. And this is Satan's destiny. And anyone who is listening and going along with these doctrines is going to have the fate of Satan. Yes, and these people, the Bible even says how they've done up these encampments from their youth. If you look in Isaiah chapter 47, verse 12, it says, stand now with thine encampment, and with the multitude of thy sorcery, wherein thou hast labored from thy youth, if so be thou shalt be able to profit, if so be thou mayest prevail. And if you look at that word enchantment, it's 2267 in your Hebrew Shas Concordance, and that says how they are able to whisper a spell over a whole society. And this is how they do it when people get unleashed, and 2266 tells you about fellowshipping with them, listening to them, and hearing what they have to say. Those spells will work on you because you're listening to their garbage. And so when you're listening to it, it wants to take over your mind. This is how they enchant people with the sorcery of the media, with the whole society, with their lives.
Okay, 1500 years after Exodus chapter 7 and 9, you find that the book of Revelation comes along, and you find out that Paul preached these messages here in 2 Timothy. Was probably one of his last books that he had preached about the last days specifically. And this was probably, I don't know, maybe 50 years before the book of Revelation. But I want you to show the people, Melanie, about 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 9. And I want you to compare these three verses, okay? Exodus chapter 9, verse 11, 10 and 11, might be 9 also, 9, 10, 11, but you compare that, in Exodus, compare this with 2 Timothy 3, 9, and also Revelation 17, if you look at that, what is it, verse 3 or 10?
Revelation being 10, 10.
Tell us about those three verses and tell us how the people should know about them now and why. Because this is confirming the validity of our Bible.
Yes, sir. Well, if you start with 2 Timothy 3, verse 9, it shows that they should proceed no further, and their folly shall be manifest unto all men, as theirs also was. So it's telling us how the people were slain and punished. Over in Exodus chapter 9, this is how they will be punished again. And it's confirmed in Revelation chapter 16, like we stated in verse 2, just that one alone. But if you want to go deeper and see how these men, these magicians, were punished, you find out in Exodus chapter 9, you can say verses 8 through 12, and it shows you where the Lord commanded Moses and Aaron to take handfuls of ashes of the furnace. And Moses was to sprinkle it toward the heavens in the sight of Pharaoh. And it became small dust. And it shall be a boil breaking forth with flames upon the man, upon the beast, and throughout all the land of Egypt. So they took the ashes from the furnace, and they sprinkled it toward heaven. And it became a boil breaking forth with flames upon man and upon beast.
Have you been telling the people what these boils and flames are, Melanie? Because they've never heard a word like this. And without a strong concordance and a King James Bible, still never know what it means, so they're not using the same words in these other books that's supposed to be so holy.
We'll even help the listeners and give them the number. You talked about the boils, it's 7822 in the Hebrew section. It talks about to burn.
You mean with a strong concordance. They can take this word, what's the word